Is Paul there? Paul who? Paul McCartney. No, he's not here. What a thrill it was to be standing there at the gate of the London home of Sir Paul with my music professor husband and his British invasion class. I had walked reverently over to inspect the intercom. Did it really work? Let's find out, said a student. Boldly, he had simply pushed the button. At 54, how could I suddenly be back inside my 14-year-old head, marveling that we had just communicated with someone in there, someone who actually saw him every day? Unbelievable, thrilling, almost up there with hearing "I Want to Hold Your Hand" for the very first time or seeing the Beatles on Ed Sullivan's Really Big Shoe. In 1964, the hardest decision I had was choosing my favorite Beatle. It had to be well thought out. You couldn't just choose willy-nilly, and you certainly couldn't be wishy-washy. You were known for your signature Beatle, so it was crucial to get it right. Sadly, I had to rule out John. He was a bit too intellectual. I just wasn't there yet. And George, with his mysterious, dark, good looks, would have appealed more to an older me. I considered at length choosing Ringo because of his down-to-earth sweet charm and his oh-so-innocent smile. Excruciatingly, it was Paul who made the final cut and became, forever and always, my favorite Beatle. I loved everything about him. The innocent sexiness of his eyes, the adorable shape of his mouth, and the special way his mop top moved when he shook his head and sang, "Woo!" Since I saw her standing there. And, oh yeah, his talent. Wow, at 54, standing at that gate, I was happy that I could still feel the same enthusiasm I had at 14. However, I wondered whether I might be exhibiting a disturbing lack of maturity, as I was definitely still starstruck. Was it ridiculous at my age to be so easily spirited away? The answer would arrive 5 years later, not in London, but in Dallas. In 2009, I was thrilled to learn that Paul McCartney would be in concert August 19th at Cowboy Stadium. But oh my, ticket prices. Once again, in teenage mode, I rationalized, this can be Christmas, birthday, Valentine's, and whatever else comes up. After the initial mandatory hesitation demanded by my husband's frugal nature, he agreed that we should go. Anticipation rose with the temperature. After 45 years, I would finally see Paul. The big day arrived with its heat and humidity, yet I had never felt cooler. I wanted to arrive with time to spare, with no rushing or traffic delays or parking issues. For once, I was determined to be early. Heading into the city, I had a phone conversation with our Dallasite daughter, who listened to my chatter, but then started questioning us about our route. I told her, as Kurt nodded agreement, "Oh, we know how to get there." "Okay," she responded, in that familiar tone a parent uses with a know-it-all teenager. "Oh, we knew how to get there, all right. We knew how to get to where the Dallas Cowboys played every single home game, in Irving." As we entered the area of the interstate where exit signs should have been, we wondered what was up. Where was the famous stadium? We were puzzled, and I began to get nervous. You see, Having dumped America's team, when they dumped Tom Landry, we had not kept up to speed on the construction of their new home. What is it the realtors say? That all-important factor? Location, location, location. I must have blocked out some of the more traumatizing details of our aimless driving, but I do remember the miracle of my husband finally pulling into a convenience store and asking where we were and how on God's green earth were we supposed to get to Cowboys Stadium. The reply, Cowboys Stadium is in Arlington. Of course, the Irving Stadium was Texas Stadium. The answer to Shakespeare's question, what's in a name, is a lot. Especially if the lot is in another city. As we headed that way, I was frantic. How could this happen? What were we thinking? Would we make it? OMG! As we arrived in Arlington, we breathed easier until we saw the traffic at a standstill. You see, in close proximity to the new Cowboys Stadium was Rangers Stadium. Who were these people going to watch baseball? With Sir Paul right next door. Were they mad? In fact, it was I who was mad, defined as insane, hysterical. In agony, I threw my head back and moaned, "We are going to miss Paul. We are right here and we are going to miss him." Desperate, I was thinking about making a run for it. But at that very moment, destiny took pity on me. Turning a corner, we saw Jerry's house, soon to be rocking, with or without us. Stop, go, repeat. Then a breakthrough. We were in the parking lot. With only minutes to spare, we made our way into entry F and through the wheelchairs lined up around the top of Blue 11. But could we find our seats? It was dark, and neither of us had brought reading glasses. Our rescuer, a nice lady in a Keep Austin Weird t-shirt, read our seat numbers, and we were in. Mesmerized, I watched as my favorite Beatle removed his black Nehru jacket after driving my car, saying, "That's the only wardrobe change of the evening." In his white shirt and red suspenders, he entertained us magnificently with his playful gait and charming mannerisms, his high energy mix of old and new, and that endearing accent. All accompanied by that twinkle in his crinkly, boyish eyes. Moving easily from the solo acoustic yesterday to the pyrotechnics of Live and Let Die and delivering two encores at 67, he still had it, and he still had me. This year, I will turn 64, and besides wondering, will you still feed me? I am amazed that only yesterday I was 14, when all my troubles seemed so far away. Recently, watching a video of My Love from that 09 concert, I felt a tingle in my spine. Must be that pinched nerve, I thought. Then, popping up right underneath the ever-youthful Paul was an ad for Medicare supplemental insurance. What? How could it be that I was their target audience? thinking about maturity, I reflected on my question. The answer is no. It is not ridiculous to be a bit starstruck, gaga, or immature. I am grateful to Sir Paul for reminding me of that magical mystery tour that occasionally transports me back 50 years to a place where I can feel 14 again. These flashbacks help me remember that the spirit never ages. I have kept this in mind for a long, long time, at least since I saw him standing there.